What up? Welcome in. Today we're going to be playing a game, as you can see, called Outward. Heard about it on a podcast called Gamers with Jobs, and it is what sounds like a very harsh game, very realistic simulator, where you have to worry about hunger, you have to worry about thirst, you have to worry about temperature. Bandages don't, you know, they take time, they don't just heal you right away. So it seems like a very life simulator-like game, and with some RPG elements in it. It sounds like something I've been wanting. I've been wanting a really good like survival style game without a ton of zombies always coming at me. Just let me do my own thing and not an MMO. It does have plenty of co-op, whether online or, you know, couch co-op, split screen. Today we're gonna be playing about an hour or so alone, and then hopefully in the near future Ale can join in. We could do a couple co-op games. All I've gone through so far is the tutorial, just kind of get the basics down, and gonna start a new game and show you guys what it's like. So change your name first. Let's see what options we have here. Just three options. Sounds realistic. Faces. Nothing crazy. Just stick with something simple like that. Hair color doesn't matter. Go ahead and create this character. Looks like that's about all we got. Just a few options there. So now in the beginning, I heard that you basically get washed up on shore, and so all my life I've lived within the safety of Cirzo, spared by brutality of the world outside, but life in REI is never that easy. For all the safety that my tribe provides, our laws are harsh. We are judged not as individuals, but as bloodlines. The failures of my bloodline weigh heavy on me. My grandmother brought ruin to our tribe long ago, bringing a heavy blood price upon my family. We've paid the debt caused by her actions ever since. I joined an expedition across the sea with my old friend Yizan, hoping the money made there would be enough to clear my debts. This was a mistake. I'm lucky to still be breathing after our ship hit rocks on the return voyage. Now I have no choice but to pick myself up yet again and face the wild, untamed land outside the walls. I must carve out my own future or die trying. Let's see what we can do. So I'm gonna pick this up. At least we have a light source. Some sort of clothes. Yeah, there's some seaweed. Don't know what that's for yet, but I'm sure we'll figure out soon. We can gather this. Yeah, big shells. I don't know if we have anything to hold water in yet.
Hey there.
Mister, you're alive. You must be freezing. Come warm up by the fire before you freeze to death. Where are we? The last thing I remember was our ship hitting a rock.
We're not far from home. You can see the lighthouse from here, can't you?
Edzo made it out to, he's making his way home. Get help, or his way home.
He's a Kazite. He was born on a ship.
This probably isn't the first time he had to survive a shipwreck.
Go ahead and sleep in one of the extra bedrolls.
I don't know if we want to sleep quite yet. These types of games, I typically spend too much time wandering around and gathering everything that I possibly can, kind of hoarding it in case I need it in the future. So it'll take some time to take a look around, see what we got. Source away. Okay, I can easily bring it back. There's some more seaweed for who knows what. Can't get in this wood. A little too far. Guess you're not supposed to be in the bush while gathering. You are thirsty. Great. There's nothing to hold water in yet. Good idea, but it's all we got, so let's see what happens. Still thirsty. Got a disease. Gather that and boil it first, which obviously did not do. Let's see what happens if we sleep here for a little bit. hours sleep, I'll be a little hungry. It's gonna be dark if I sleep too long. Or light. The more I sleep, maybe we missed something. Oh. Drink clean water. Still have an illness, though. Just a dead person. I didn't miss something over here. Alright. Well, we found the clean water. I'm getting hungry, but we did pick up that bread. Go rest and see if that progresses the storyline a bit. Just a couple hours. So far, very realistic simulator, obviously. Drinking salt water I knew wasn't going to be a good idea, and that showed. Unconsciousness comes quickly, and you dream of being ensnared in something. With a yelp, you jump out of your bed. Relief floods you as you recognize where you are. You are back in your old bed at home, the lighthouse. Zahn must have brought you back to your family's lighthouse, only your aching body tells you that the shipwreck you suffered was not a nightmare. Worker boots, some different attire. Still nothing to hold water in. This is going to give us 13.
Rise and shine, Trog spawn. You think you can nip off for 4 months and not pay what you owe the tribe?
A blood price is sacred. You can't just shrug off that responsibility.
If I don't see the money from you by the time I count to 10, you'll regret you ever came home. Ship too, weren't you? How many lives must your family be responsible for destroying before enough is enough?
I lost my daughter on that voyage, so that probably wasn't a good response. Bring ruin to the tribe just like your grandmother. So it doesn't change the fact I have no money right now and can't pay you.
If you can't make the payments you missed, we will seize your home!
I have to cover 4 months of ignoring your duty to the tribe. Either pay up or get out of
the way. Enough of this! 12 people are dead! Stop this shameful behavior at once!
It's time for our tribe to come together and mourn our lost loved ones, not demand payment from a survivor.
To threaten someone like this while the lost lives are still fresh is an insult to their memory.
I've declared a period of mourning. I understand what that means to me.
But, Chamber Lady Aberdeen!
It's just clearly been.
I said that is enough! If you want to resume discussions after the mourning period, feel free.
Until then, your concern should be for those whose lives lost.
Oliel, see these people off, would you?
You heard, Mother. Away with you, or I will personally see to it that you get double shifts of guard duty.
I'm sorry that was the first thing you woke up to. Please forgive them. Many of them have lost family and are not thinking straight. If I could do more, I would. The most I can do for you is declare a mourning period and buy you a little time.
You cannot pay off for 4 months. I've missed payments on your own. The tribe will have my head. For 5 days, no one in the tribe can ask for what you owe.
That gives you a few days to pay back the money.
5 days.
Either gather the money or earn a tribal favor, and they won't be able to touch you. Once you can make the payment, come see me. Please, find a way to make it work.
The last thing I want to do is take your lighthouse away. This blood price is unfair. Then I will have to head to the outside walls.
That does seem like your most effective option, dangerous as it is. Never forget, no one is an orphan in Cierzo. Do not hesitate to ask the rest of the tribe for survival advice. If you can do a great deed for someone in Cierzo, we will owe you a tribal favor.
I'll accept a substitute for your payment.
Once you're ready to leave Sierzo, speak with Burak, the Gate Warden.
Judge whether or not you are prepared to face the next step.
Remember, you only have a few days. May your ancestors watch over you.
Alright, 5 days to get 150 silver coins.
I'm glad you survived the wreck.
That glowing sword is new. Where did you get
Rufus it? Rufus commissioned it for me as a going away present. But with the shipwreck, it wouldn't be right to leave so soon.
So let's drive until the mourning period is over.
I have faith in you. You'll pull through. Farewell, my friend.
I was hoping that we could get that sword. There's not going to be anything much worthwhile. Just laying around. A weapon.
Amber, my friend.
Ready to continue my training. Teach you how to fight. Teach you how to actually fight.
First, you'll have better chance of avoiding attention if you're in the dark.
Without any lit lanterns or torches, and crouch down. Enemy's vision. You sneak past them, carefully approach them to attack. It's all real life stuff. These buildings.
Blessings of Alat upon you.
Just leave.
What can I do for you?
Oh,
here's what I need.
Whoa.
What was that?
All right.
Fishing harpoon.
Hey there. Here's the plan.
Running low, crystal powder.
Hey, listen.
Hold up there. Where do you think you're going?
We're outside.
Oh, not like that you aren't. You need at least an equipped weapon, a water skin, and an equipped backpack before you're ready to face the outside world. If I let you adventure outside without basic equipment, you'd be marching to your own death. If you're pressed to find a weapon, make yourself a quarterstaff. I'm also sure you can find a spare water skin by the water purifier on the town beach. Whoa! Hold up there. Where do you think? Oh, not like that you aren't. You need at least an equipped weapon, a water skin, and an equipped backpack before you're ready to face the outside world. If I let you adventure, if you're pressed to find a weapon, make yourself a quarterstaff. I'm also sure you can find a spare water skin by the water purifier on the town beach.
Staff. craft a bigger backpack if we can. Skeleton will walk in. Is this axe good enough?
Greetings, friend.
Something for you. I'm here about work.
Lend me your ear.
There's something I can do.
As a matter of fact, I could use a brash explorer for something.
What would you risk for some silver? My life in danger.
Here's what I need.
Rare mushroom in the shape of a shield. Worcester Borough, northeast.
You'll know it if you find it.
Size and red color. Mushroom. 70 silver. That's a good amount. Sounds like an adventure. I'll do it.
Perfect. Make sure you have a good weapon, a lantern, and plenty of supplies.
Great, it's a dangerous cave. Your life on the line. Trunks have very poor eyesight, but fantastic.
Lend me your ear.
On the road to the left, so we get to number four.
I'll see you.
Let's see if we can do this. Sea salt. Spending way too much time in this town. I have an axe and a hat.
Need something?
I'm going outside.
Well, you got the essentials at least. Here, I'll teach you a skill.
Mastering these is key to survival out in the wild. Teach you one for your weapon you're currently holding.
There you go. Mastering skills is the key to survival out in the wild.
You should look for trainers whenever you visit a town. They'll usually group your training equipment. Others need to be sought out.
All right. I feel comfortable letting you outside the walls. Use the door when you want to head out.
Stay safe out there. Farewell. Where are skills? Two-handed axe. High damage. Strike, it does twice as damage against knockdown foes. Okay. That's pretty easy. I don't know what I'm getting myself into here. We'll find out. It's a little creepy. I like it. Right, go left. I don't know if we're really prepared to get that mushroom. Moving. Something happened right here. Yep, they're going to attack me. I don't know if they're friendly or not. Plan here. So bad. I'm gonna need a bandage up though. A little mask. Put a mask on. It's a part of the hat. It's a part of the hat. Bandage up real quick. Ourselves into here. A bandit camp. That's not what I meant to do. Pick that up. Stuff. Wait. I'll go back and sell some stuff and then come back. Yep. Hey, we got some free stuff just laying here. Already night. Put that out. Wait. I wonder if we get enough of these. Sell it. It's worth it. I think it's so good. There's some way of getting 150 silver. Hard to see. I'll just switch back. Our lighthouse. Put this away now. Let's see if we can sell this stuff.
What can I do for you? All right.
Okay. Fishing harpoon. We only need that for food. Sell this. Sell that. Boots were worth to the gym. That's worth two.
What can I do for you? All right.
15. Indigestion curing tea. This storage. Maybe there's some stuff we can steal out of here. Everything. Thank you. to heal. Just go back home. We are going to go back there and we're going to mine some stuff. This looks like I'm going the right way. Let's sell some of the stuff that we just found. Lighten our load up a little bit. Make some jams. Oh, yeah, we're hungry. I think it's right there. Some bread. There we go. Alright. Let's go back out. Sell some stuff. And get to that 150. This is day 2. Go back and get those guys. So far, it's not as hard as people made it sound. It is still just the beginning. So, let's see.
What can I do for you? All right.
Get this 150. Can't move. I need a better backpack. Too late last night. Need to sleep. Something. Come back and get it. We're almost there. Struggling, but we're getting there. Zero ourselves time to this guy over here.
What can I do for you? All right. What can I do for you? All right.
Thank you. wasn't as much to do as I thought. So I'm missing something.
What can I do for you? All right.
Raise your arms, shielding your vulnerable throat from the animals that howl at you, and brace yourself for death. Fangs sink into your leg, and you feel yourself dragged across the ground. Every rock and bump causes jolts of pain that knock you into darkness for a while. When you finally come to and open your eyes, you see the half-eaten leg of some poor explorer inches from your face. Hyenas howl nearby, hungry for flesh. Clearly, dinner has been served. Yikes. So, give me something more silver. Nope. Metal that they are fast. Die again. You force your eyes open and find yourself in a cart with prisoners and corpses bouncing along the road. A corpse hanging from a gibbet passes your vision as unconsciousness takes you. You know that you have been taken prisoner by the Montcalm tribe. Hours later, you open your eyes again, imprisoned within the Montcalm village. You have no doubt they intend for your corpse to join the others dangling outside. Hey.